Hey guys, I'm Bryan Williams with WGR, and today we're going to show you how to do a 3-point calibration on your pH pen. So, let's get started. First, let me tell you about why it's important to calibrate your equipment. It's really important that you calibrate your equipment because over time and lots of use of the equipment, it gets uncalibrated and will no longer read properly. So it's important that you calibrate your equipment once a week if possible, definitely before each use if you can, and if you've stored it for 30 days without usage, also calibrate it then. So now that you know when to calibrate it, let's talk about calibration logs. It's important that you record all the information in a calibration log because the Industrial General Permit and the Construction General Permit both mandate that you keep a 3-year record of all the calibrations done on each device. So once you have proved that you've calibrated, it's really important to do the proper storage and rinsing of your equipment. Now, on these electrode rinse packets, you'll notice that it says high purity deionized water. And it's really important that you know when to use the deionized water and when to not use it. When storing your device, never use deionized water. Simply place a few drops of water onto a piece of paper towel inside your cap with either tap water or storage solution provided by your pH pen manufacturer. Now, let's start our 3-point calibration. So, the first thing I'm gonna do is take off my cap carefully, and it's a good idea that you take out the cloth inside there so that you'll remember that you didn't store it with the old one. Now, we can take our cap off and then simply press the on button. This device is really nice and simple because there's only 3 buttons and it makes it a whole lot easier to use. So before using it, you can rinse it off, give it a little shake, and now we're going to enter the calibration mode. What we do is we just press the CAL button right here, and then we're gonna drop it in the 7 buffer solution. So I'm gonna hold this in here, I'm gonna give it a little stir, and what I'm gonna have to do is let it sit here for 1 to up to 2 minutes, and then the numbers should correspond with each other. It's noticed that it's in the 7-point solution, and it's reading at fluctuating in between 7.11 and 7.12. So we'll set this down, and we'll wait for 2 minutes, and come back and press the enter button to calibrate it. All right, so it's been 2 minutes, so let's take a look at our device and see what's going on. It's not fluctuating anymore, and you can see that it's at 7.11. Now it's gonna be moving around just a little bit because I disturbed the water inside there, but now you'll see it's flat. This is the time where I'm just gonna press enter right here. You'll see it blink, and now it's been calibrated. What I recommend is you rinse it off right now and give it a quick rinse, shake off the excess water, and move on to the next buffer. Now I'm gonna go on to the 10 buffer solution, and see, it already recognizes that it's in the 10.1 solution, and now we're gonna wait and do the same process and allow it to calibrate there. So we'll set this down for about 1 or 2 minutes also, and then come back in a little bit. Okay, so now that our 2 minutes are over, let's take a look at our device. And it's relatively less jumping around, and it's a lot more stable. So right now is the time that we come and press enter. And you'll see the numbers change to 10.1, and there you have it. It's just been calibrated at the 10 buffer solution. So what we're gonna do is rinse this off once more, shake off the excess water, and now we'll do the last and final part of our 3-point solution. So we're gonna place this in the 4 buffer solution and repeat the process. We're already in calibration mode, and this one is bouncing around a lot closer to the actual solution, so that's a good sign. What it's gonna do is we're just gonna repeat that process of 1 to 2 minutes of wait time, and then we're gonna go in there and press the calibration enter button. Now that your device has been sitting for about 2 minutes, let's take a look at it, and we're gonna press the enter for the last time and calibrate it. So, now that I've calibrated this device, I'm gonna give it a quick rinse, and we're going to go into storage prep mode. So I can start by turning the device off, and let's get our rag ready. Just a small little piece of a paper towel. I'm going to fold it in thirds, and I'm just going to put a few drops of water on it. So now that I've put a few drops of water on it, I can spread the water around, fold it up again, and then just simply stick that down there in the bottom of it. And now my electrode will not dry out. So this just keeps your device healthy, and it'll give you a little bit more longevity in your device. And it's important to do this just so you can keep your equipment well maintained. Make sure that's nice and snug. Set it back in your box. And you'll probably want to write everything down in your log that just went on. So you're going to have to write the date, time, general notes and comments. You're going to write, if you have multiple devices, make sure you put the device number that's going on there so you can keep track of what's being calibrated. And just a general tip, when you're performing calibrations, make sure that your solution packets, if you use them, are not expired. You can see the expiration date right here. It says 7 of 2016. And right here, this one also expires in 7 of 2016. So just ensure that you have non-expired materials and make sure that you're writing everything down in your calibration logs. So there's everything you need to know about how to do a 3-point calibration for your pH pen.